The firing of a popular school superintendent is raising an awful lot of questions tonight. People are demanding to know why. Right now, the Pajaro Valley Union School Board is holding a special meeting to name an interim replacement. We get more on the firing and tonight's meeting from Action News 8 reporter Felix Cortez, live in Salinas. Felix, this was people felt blindsided here.
That's exactly what happened. That's what they feel like, Dan. And right now, dozens of letters are being read at that school board meeting. And what we've heard so far, all of them in support of the ousted superintendent, and many of them, those letters raising questions as to the timing of this firing. It comes as the school district, like many around the state, struggle to educate during a pandemic.
Pajaro Valley Unified School District Superintendent Michelle Rodriguez fired Wednesday night by a slim 4-3 vote. Rodriguez says she never saw this coming and wasn't told why she was being let go.
And I certainly did not do anything illegal or unethical. And I believe I should have had the right to at least hear from the board members their concerns, which I, to date, have not heard.
Superintendent Rodriguez had led the district the last 4.5 years. She signed a new 4-year contract just months ago, her termination coming less than a day after her father passed away. Supporters saying her firing couldn't have come at a worse time, as school districts struggle to educate during a pandemic and teachers are next in line to get vaccinated.
Why would you do that? The board is there to represent everybody, and you know, they're supposed to be making decisions in the best interest of this whole community. How does this support the whole community right now? How does this help us when we're already struggling? It's salt on a wound. It's insult to injury.
A petition now circulating to reinstate the ousted superintendent and demanding answers as to why Rodriguez was fired. As of Friday afternoon, more than 1,500 people had signed it.
You know, I've experienced probably the toughest 36 hours of my life, so I do really appreciate the outpouring of support that they've shown for me. I hope that the board reconsiders their decision, sees that there was not cause to invoke my early termination.
And one way for that to happen is if a board member makes a motion tonight to rescind the previous decision and reinstate Superintendent Rodriguez. Just before we went on air, the school board was still listening to those letters that were submitted by more than 200 people. We'll be following this board meeting and have their decision tonight on Action News 8 at 11. Reporting from Salinas, I'm Felix Cortez, KSBW, Action News 8.